Oh my god.
Hey y'all, Aman here. You're watching Heart Limits. So I find it amazing how whenever people think of theme parks, or some people call it as amusement parks, they always go for the most death-defying, scary rides, and usually it's the roller coaster. Me, I'm terrified of roller coasters. And I think it's mainly because I don't have any control on the speed and the direction where the coaster is going. So whenever people think of roller coasters or want to ride on one, there's always this signage, you know, somewhere by the entrance where you buy the tickets or where the queue basically begins. And there's always these warnings, like if you have a heart problem, if you recently had, let's say, some type of medical procedure, if you have back problems, neck problems. They even mention the possibilities that if you're too small or too tall, or rather short, it's the same as small, so whatever. If you're too small, too short, or you're too tall. So there are these precautions, but has it never occurred to you why it actually is the case for people with heart problem? So for me to answer this, I'm actually going to have to explain to you that there are a couple of things that actually happen when you ride a roller coaster. First of all, blood goes to your feet, and at times it goes to your head. So when does this actually occur? So here, the definition of G-force comes into place. You know, I don't mean the one that you find inside the computer, the graphics card and all that, no. I mean the G-force, which is the gravitational force. So normally, current state, when something is in free fall, that would be considered as G1 or G-force 1. But as more it accelerates, the rate increases. So let's say, for instance, someone weighs 100 pounds. That is his weight in a G-force setting of 1. If you go to a speed of G-force 2, his weight, which was 100, will then become 200, so to say. So there are G-forces that are at play, and the more downward, accelerated downward speed that you go, that actually gives you the negative G-force. And in this situation, if you go at the number which is extremely high in the G-force, what happens is all the blood actually goes to your brain and everything starts turning red. You know, and the problem with that is once there's too much on your head and that negative G-force, you could actually, more so than not just pass out and all, you could actually die. And the human body can basically only take about a maximum of this of 3 or 4 G's on that type. And the cool thing is when this happens, since it's a negative G-force, so instead of it actually giving you more weight, it goes the other way around. It gives you this feeling of weightlessness. You know that part where you're like, whoa, oh, whatever. Anyway, so you have that type of G-force. And the other one is the G-force where you go really fast on incline. And when that happens, that's the part where you feel like you're a fish. And when that happens, is that part is when the blood actually goes all the way down to your feet. And when that happens, here you have this thing called the gray out. And when there's a gray out, that's the part where your vision starts to get blurry. And at times, some people pass out. And usually, this is the type where fighter pilots feel this type of sensation. When they're in that vertical incline, and some people actually pass out. And fighter pilots usually go to around the G-force of 8 or 9, and that is in consideration that they actually have a G-force suit. So I never thought there was such a thing, but it actually constricts part of your legs and your abdomen so that it makes sure that the blood stays above and has a way to still travel to the brain. And for me, I find it mind-blowing that there's an actual suit that fighter pilots actually wear. You know, I always thought that it wasn't a pre-existing thing. Maybe it would only apply to, you know, those rockets that are launched to space. But apparently, those rockets that launch to space, it's also a different kind of G-force, and it apparently doesn't go as high as those fighter pilots. I'm still surprised with that, to be honest. So the beauty with roller coasters is that it's actually a big science, and it's a whole experience. Not only is it driven by the lights, the vibrations, the speeds, the turns, you know, it's even the screams that you hear. And the science to it is actually how much positive and negative G-forces are present. And that's actually not the only type of G-force. So positive and negative is more for the up and down, but there's also G-forces which are rather quite linear. So moving forward really fast, or moving backward, moving backward really fast. And there also is, you know, this quick whiplash to the left or right, that's also another type of G-force. But on a roller coaster, those super sides aren't a bit too much. They don't do it too much because it makes the ride a bit too uncomfortable. So they kind of try to smoothen out a bit the sides, because the most enjoyable feelings are those where you go all the way up, all the way down, speed forward and speed back. And what I find funny is that whenever I thought of roller coasters, I always thought that the point where your heart beats really fast is the point when there is so much G-force. But actually, even though there is a contributing factor to that, it isn't that big of a deal. The biggest factor is actually still the psychological one. And in my previous video, I talked about, can you be scared to death? Apparently, that is still the biggest contributing factor. And the point is, I find it interesting because I think I can kind of understand already. Because whenever I see a roller coaster, and especially when I'm on one, I always hated that sound. When you are going up slowly, for me, that point, I'm like, oh my god, oh my god. And it's interesting because some people find so much excitement in that. But for me, oh, I literally just become pale and just hold on tight. So whenever that happens, there's actually a couple of things that starts to manifest. And that's where your adrenaline starts coming in. That's when your norepinephrine, whatever that's called, starts to come in. Bah! And when those things come in, suddenly your senses are sharpened, all your muscles start, you know, receiving all the oxygenated blood and everything. And at that point, it's like your body is ready to take on everything. Because the body knows and it already senses the threat. Senses the fear, or it could even just be the excitement. Well, sometimes people, of course, get on a roller coaster because, oh, I love the feeling. But there's an undeniable fact that your body is already reacting to the situation. Even though you might say you are not scared, the body can sense the danger or the incoming danger. So if you want your body to react safely in some way, the best way is to actually look forward, keep your head straight, so that your body can react quicker. Problem is, whenever you close your eyes or you look to the side, your inner ear gets confused and your body has a hard time keeping up with the situation. And you will just like totally freak out. And, of course, the best part is people like to scream. Well, it's a good thing. it's good to release that fear. Because if you don't, there are times you're just... Not only do you look constipated, it's also quite disturbing. So, given that your inner ear gets confused, the problem is your inner body, there's also organs and all of this. They're not really fixed in, so to speak. So whenever you're in the roller coaster, your organs start moving around. Your head starts to move there. Of course, there's this like, how would you call it? It's like a bubble, not really a bubble. It's like this, some sort of squishy thing which kind of protects your brain on impact, on sharp turns. It's there, but of course, there's still times it still hits parts of the skull. Especially when you're in a roller coaster, you know, the whiplash. So, yeah. And the awesome thing with riding a roller coaster, I don't really think it's awesome, but some people will say it is awesome. Because your body felt that fear incoming situation, your muscles have delivered everything, you will notice that your neck muscles are starting to function. It's readying for that brace and impact because it knows that if it is not strengthened and it is the way it is, you could literally break your neck. So, riding a roller coaster is quite safe in some way with regards to, well, the chances of someone dying on a roller coaster because of a failure in the mechanical issue is really small. The biggest problem with a roller coaster is the part where you perceive that fear. And of course, the added contribution that your own body also releases adrenaline and norepinephrine. Whatever. Problem with that is there's this sudden increase in blood pressure and heart rate, and if your heart isn't strong enough, you cannot keep up with the ride. And maybe even just at the part where it's the ascent, people might laugh at you. You're like, imagine that's the part you die. You know, most people don't know that that's really the part where the heart is at its peak, but some people might just be like, what? It hasn't even started yet and he already died. So, in my opinion, if you do have a heart problem, please maybe think twice about riding a roller coaster because people might find you quite sad and depressing. And the problem is, not everyone knows that they actually have a heart problem. And it's the case many times, and of course, not everyone rides a roller coasters every day in their lives, so they wouldn't know. And there are times that, a couple of times rather, where people get on a roller coaster without knowing that they have a heart problem. In those instances, of course, you should be worried, but normally, there is a defibrillator on hand with the roller coaster operator. So, I guess kind of don't worry so much if you have a heart attack. They're gonna shock you back to life or something. Well, it's not really great in that way, but of course it's also sad if you live in fear, right? So anyway, once again, Aman here, you're watching Heart Limits. So if you have a weak heart or if you have a heart problem, think twice about riding a roller coaster. So, once again, see ya.